Hello and welcome back to another episode of the EMC Generator series. I am back from holiday, and as promised, I am going to do a video. And today's video is going to be the sugarcane farm. Yay! Woo! Okay, so all I've done so far is I've made four two wide columns of dirt with water adjacent, and I've made them 10 blocks long. As you guys have probably started to figure out now, this design can be made as long, as deep, and layered, if you wish. This is just a very basic design, to give you a rough idea. The first thing I'm going to do is take this harvest ring off my inventory, because I'm sick and tired of all this wild grass propping up. Okay, so let's get rid of all this crepe. Oh, no, just fall in the water. Okay, so once you've got these dirt columns going, the next thing you want to do is take some redstone tubing. And let's get started. So your pedestal is going to be sitting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. So anywhere like here. We'll plonk it here. Just because. Make sure you take the water away from underneath it, or else these two blocks will suffer. We'll just pop the pedestal there for now, but we won't pop the ring in. So pop your pedestal down like that, and get your redstone tubing. It's going to be coming out the front like this and into a chest here, so this is as good a place as any to start. So we'll just go like this. Okay, so the way this is going to work is you're going to have one sugarcane, and then you're going to have a space, and then you're going to have a block breaker. So so we need to leave one for the sugarcane, two for the block breaker. So then on the third one, it's got to be the redstone tubing. So that's one, that's two. So this should be fine to have it come like this. Excellent. Okay, so now all you want to do is, I like to run this down the middle, just straight down the middle, and that can make sure that all the pipes all come onto the same area. Now this is where it's going to take a lot of piping, because you need to make sure that you have a piece of piping above every section of grass. And I just realised it's about to turn night time, which is what we don't want. Let's make it morning again. So you need to have redstone tubing above every single piece of dirt. So your entire area is going to literally look like this, like all the way along both sides. So to save us a little bit of time, I am going to pause the video and come back when I have set up all the redstone tubing. So I shall be back in a moment. Okay, I'm back. So all I've done is I have put the redstone wiring, redstone tubing even, sorry, all the way along. I've left a gap where the water is because you don't particularly need it there. So you just 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2 all the way down, and just as you can see, I've just done that all the way along on all the dirt. So the next thing we need to do is place our block breakers. This is another tedious task. All you need to do is just look up directly at the redstone tubing and just go all the way along placing block breakers. So I had one of these on my last multiplayer survival map, and it was a little bit bigger than this, but only ever so slightly, and it was making me a diamond every sort of like 15 seconds, maybe 16 seconds. And seeing as all you're actually, the most expensive thing you're using here is obviously the pedestal and the ring. That's about it. Like, the actual materials you're using other than that, like the block breakers and the redstone tubing and the timers and all of that gubbins, it's actually like very cheap really, because block breakers are really just iron. That's all they really are. So I mean, if you wanted to make this without the pedestal with the harvester ring on it, then you could. It obviously would be absolutely nowhere near as effective, but if you're talking about just having a constant stream of EMC coming in, then you might want to consider doing it without the pedestal. It'll be a lot cheaper, and you can make it like really, really big for the same amount. But I mean, I like using the pedestal because it makes it incredibly fast. So we've put down all of our block breakers now. So as you can see, you've just gone two all the way down. Now I need to take some sugarcane. And all we're going to do is we're just going to go like this and fill up every spot with sugarcane. Oh, dear. Like so. So how this works is it takes, once the sugarcane has grown one, it will instantly go in range of the block breaker and it will break it and send it down the tubing. A lot of sugarcane farms work by using pistons to push the sugarcanes like over, like just above the like source block of the sugarcane, and it makes them sort of like fall into a water current or, you know, whatever. Oh, I've run out of sugarcane. Okay, well, we'll continue the video without filling in those last couple of spots. Actually, I'll tell you what, I'll go and grab some now quickly. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Right, I've got some more sugarcane now. I just had to walk all the way back to my base to get more sugarcane, which is a pain in the ass. But oh well. Okay. We've done the hard part now. So now what we want to do is get rid of this guy here. And we want to replace him with an energy condenser. Like so. Then we'll chuck a diamond. Oh, I've got conveniently have a diamond in my inventory. That wasn't planned. That was just there. Okay, so now what you need is you need a redstone current timer to go to these tubings here. Now what we're going to do is, last time I checked this, if you sent it off via the middle, it seemed to work okay. So we'll give that a go. So we're going to go one off like this, just as middle as you can get it, basically. I didn't really count that out, but I'm pretty sure that's in the middle-ish. Then you want to go like this, put two blocks in front of it, like so. Then you want to go like that. And all that does is it creates a current. And that appears to be spreading perfectly. Yes, it does work. So you go redstone like that, and then you just put a timer down like that. And that will carry the current everywhere on the contraption. I like to bring these down to 1 second intervals. In fact, to be on the safe side, I would bring it down to 70 milliseconds, just because if the sometimes there is bugs that if the sugarcane grows too quickly before it gets broken, it like glitches out in the block breaker and it gets weird. Okay, so here we go. So that's all working perfectly now. So they're all ticking over. Hold down shift, second click, chuck the ring in there. Second click the pedestal without holding shift. Oh god, look at all the sugarcane already coming flying down. And there you have it. That is your very own sugarcane farm. And its yield is frankly ridiculous. Look at it. I mean, that is just unbelievable. That is like constantly producing. Like, that isn't just like a harvest that happens every 3 minutes or whatever. That is just constantly going. Look at it. And that is how quickly you can make diamonds using the sugarcane farm. And if you like, if your server is like constant, if you've got a multiplayer server that runs overnight, and you have got a world anchor, if you want to know how to make a little world anchor gadget, then check out my other videos. And put it here, like, you'd come back the next night and you would have like 2 stacks of diamonds, and that would pay for your pedestal. So it's like, you know, it pays for itself in a very short period of time. So yeah, that is the sugarcane farm. Next video, I think we're going to be covering a creep grinder for EMC farm, because it's pretty good. If you guys have anything that you want me to build and do a tutorial on, like anything you can think of that I haven't already covered, then just make a comment or send me a message and I'll build it. You know, I'll build it. So just let me know and I will get on it. So I've been DCY Stezza. It's nice to be back from holiday. Enjoy the video.